Hi all, this is Karthik. Welcome to my channel Tech Solution. Today in this video session, I will discuss about some basic things. It's nothing but I am going to discuss about visual editor. Okay, there are files called cat to create the file. There are one more dots to create the empty file. There are one more also like that called vi. Is nothing but vi editor, visual editor. Or nowadays the new versions of that called VIM is nothing but finally we used to say that visual editor. Okay, so how we are managing that file, and inside that suppose take an example in your configuration file, there have hell lot of parameter would be there, or there are n number of lines are there. Okay, to remember which parameter it's written on which number of line, and in a certain particular parameter what we are going to change, or if today we have changed something in a particular parameter, and after 5 days we are going to change the same parameter, we may not remember that particular line number, right? So what we'll do, if we know very well about it, so we can set the, you know, there are one more thing called colon set underscore nu. By that we can get to know how many number lines are there and which particular lines we changed. By that also we can come to know, and this is in VI we can get like this way. In VIM what's happening, whatever things is changeable, I mean whatever parameters can changed, those parameters it will show you by, you know, color, yellow color, blue color or green color. So in future when you're going to change the same parameter, or we are going to change something else in that particular configuration file, if you open the same file by VIM, so whatever changes may have done, or whatever parameter can change, whatever parameter can edit, those things it will come like colorful, so that your iPhone first will interact with the color lines, so that it will be really easy for you to find out whether wherever those parameters are available and which parameter you do look and you do have intention to change something else in that, so and so, right? So however it is, this is the difference between VI and VIM, but both of the things it's one only, nothing else. Both of the things, the work of nature is one only. So let's go ahead to do something else in a particular configuration file where lots of parameter would be there, so that we'll get to know how it's used to work in the real environment or in your workstation. Okay, so let me open a configuration file called vi slash etc slash sss slash sshd sshd underscore slash etc ssh and slash sshd underscore config. So this is the configuration file of ssh. Okay, in that we are going to perform something else. So in that, because of this is a configuration file, so I don't want to make any disturbance. So what I will do, let me come out from this, let's create a new file by vi. Suppose I'll create suppose I'll give file name is ora dv test, hit enter key, escape i means insert mode, escape i. So here I want to write this file is belongs to ora dv. These people are using the this file for a testing purpose. Okay, and all are having owner permission for this file. If still they want to change the file permission, they can reach to us according to their request. We can give permission. Suppose this is the so and so data I return, whatever it. Okay, now I want to save this file. How I'll save this file? Just escape shift colon WQ exclamation mark. W is nothing but write, Q is nothing but quit, and W is nothing but write and save, Q is nothing but quit. Exclamation is nothing but to prompt use the hash prompt. This is what. So this file has been saved. Whether this file has been saved or not, how we'll come to know? If we can open once again, we can come to know. What was that file name? The file name was oradb test, right? So if you'll open by cat oradb test, it will show you whatever data is available there. So suppose take an example, this anyway, this is the file I want to enter in this file. How I enter? If I want to edit some data or if you want to delete some data, whatever I want to do in that. So first of all, I need to enter in that, then only I can do that, right? So I need to enter, I have to enter by visual editor and give that file. Now I already enter in that, right? If I want to edit something, how I can edit? See, as I mentioned, if you want to save something, suppose take an example, you want to come extremely end, so escape shift G, okay, then escape I. So here I want to write something, okay. Now I want to save it. How will save? Escape shift colon W Q exclamation mark, right? So shift colon W Q exclamation mark, what you will do, the same thing also, if you execute X exclamation mark, it will work as well, the same thing it will work, okay. And escape shift ZZ also, it will work for the same. Suppose take an example again, I want to enter oradb test. Here what I'll do, I want to come extremely end and I want to create one more line here, okay. My name is Karthik, okay. So I return something like that, but I don't want to save this. Suppose by mistake I change something, some parameter in a configuration file, but still I don't want to change. So what I need to do, without change I need to come out from this configuration file, right? So what I'll do, escape shift colon, okay, Q, hit enter key, Q or Q exclamation, whatever it, okay, hit enter key. Now come out, escape shift colon Q, hit enter key. Escape shift colon Q. Only Q is not working. Only Q is working in Linux, but here only Q is not working. We need to give Q and exclamation mark, okay, to come out to whenever you have done any mistake in a configuration file, but still if you don't want to make that changes, then you can execute as you can come by like that only, escape shift colon Q exclamation mark. Suppose again let me enter in that configuration, in this file vi ora db test, okay. Once I enter here, I want to add something, where is my cursor available, okay. So what I'll do, escape a. So see where my cursor was available, t only, right? Once I execute escape a, then I am able to add some data after t, okay. This is what. So suppose my cursor is here, my cursor is blinking on h, okay. I want to add some data, or take an example, I am here, Okay, I want third line. So third line end, I want to add some data. How can I add? Just escape, then shift A. My cursor will come to end. Here, give space, whatever you want to add, you can add. Okay. So, and how I can erase? If you want to erase something, just escape R. Escape R, it's erasing. See, instead of that, R has come. Okay, escape R. Suppose come here, N. I want to erase N. Escape R, R, erase. Right? So, and if you want to replace a entire line, suppose I am available here, I am available here. Okay, I want to erase this entire line. So how can I erase? Just give escape, then shift R. Escape, shift R. It's not working in Solaris. Okay, Linux it used to work. So some of the things which is not to work in Solaris, and some of the things which is not to work in Linux as well. Okay. We suppose not to compare 100%. If 100% units can comparable, then there should not have different person, there should not have different vendor, right? So this is what. And suppose you want to add something in which line. Suppose here my line is available, right? AKZR. And just before of that, one line is there where it's clearly mentioned AKFDZR, something like that, right? In between that, I want to create one more line. How I'll create? Just give escape and O. Escape. What happening here? Escape. O. See, now it is done. Here, if you want to type something, you can type. Right? Suppose I am here. Suppose take an example. I am here. Some recording, something or whatever is mentioned. I want to create if and this R, right? I want to create one more line above of recording. How I can write? Escape shift O. Escape shift O. Now see, one more line has been created, right? On top of recording, they are create something like that, right? So suppose take an example. This there is there, right? So I want to change the word. I want to change the word. I will change escape shift shift W. Now it should not happen like that. Suppose come here, escape C W. You want to write something, that word is moving and you are able to type in the different word, right? This is what. So suppose you want to delete a particular word, you want to delete a particular word, what you'll do? Escape DW. So see, now there has been deleted, right? Suppose I want to delete a particular character. Okay, I'll do escape X X X X. See, now I'm able to delete to a single character, right? Suppose take an example, I want to delete particular line at a time, so escape double D. Now this line has been deleted, right? Suppose now I want to delete number of line. I want to delete number of line. How I will delete? Suppose I am available here, 1 2 3. I want to delete first 3 line, or take an example, I want to delete I want to delete first 3 line. So I will do escape escape 3 TD. See, first 3 line has been deleted, right? Whatever changes has done, I want to make it undo. How I will do? Escape U. See, first 3 line has been deleted, now came. Again U is gone. Again U is gone, right? So whatever undo, that is nothing but whatever has erased, those things can come. Undo, redo, whatever it. Okay, that. Suppose I want to copy one line or two line, whatever it. Okay, suppose I want to copy this first line. Okay, I will copy escape YY and I want to paste somewhere. So suppose I want to paste here, so escape P. See, that line has been copied and pasted here, right? Suppose take an example, I want to copy this line. Okay, so escape yy, and I want to paste above this j. So how? Escape shift v. See, above j is paste, right? And now suppose take an example here, how many? 1 2 3 4 5. I want to copy this first 5 line, so escape 5 yy. Okay, and I want to paste completely down. So what I'll do? Escape t. See, first 5 line has been copied and pasted here, right? And suppose something is changed. Okay, I want to redo that, so I will do escape control r. Escape, then control r. Escape u. Suppose take an example, I want to delete this. Done. Then escape control shift r. Escape u, that is coming. Escape control r. Escape control shift r. Escape control r. Escape r. Suppose these two I haven't deleted, right? Then escape r, escape control r, escape control shift r, escape control r, escape u. Okay, undo is working in Solaris, redo is not working. Okay, don't think so, it will not work. It will be working, might be I'm not giving the proper option, so that it's not showing. But I'll update in the comment section what was the issue, why it's not working, right? Now, suppose take an example, I am here, I'm middle of somewhere, or middle of line or end of the line, wherever. Okay, I want to bring that cursor beginning of the line. So how I can bring? Escape gg. Escape gg. No, gg also, it's not working in the Solaris. Now suppose you want to move, you want to move your cursor word by word. So I will move escape b. See, my cursor is moving backward word by word, isn't it? Suppose you want to move your cursor forward word by word, so w. See, it's forwarding one by, right? Now, how many lines are there? How will come to know? Escape shift colon set nu. Hit enter key. It will show you how many lines are there. Okay. If you want to remove, then escape. If you want to remove line numbers, escape shift colon. You need to write here set none. It will remove the line numbers. Then suppose I want to give escape shift colon set nu, and now I am at 17 line only, right? Suppose directly I want to come line number 5. So how I can come? Shift colon, then give line number here. Your cursor will come directly to line 5. Okay. suppose you want to switch to a particular word. So how will switch? Escape, set color, then give slash and give the word. Suppose I want to give C. Here is available C, CCW, here also CCW. So I give CCW. See, CCW can. Okay, directly can do CCW. Suppose instead of that, I want to give here for. Give for. Okay, why it's not coming? Let me come to start. Escape, set color. For hit enter key. For is available this line? Yes, for is available this line. So this line for is available? No, it's not available, right? So at a time it will come the first line only. Okay, then if you'll come to here again, give again type for hit enter key, it will come next where. In which line for each available, like that only it will come. Okay. Suppose do one thing. Come to beginning of line and beginning of sentence. Here I want to change something the line. So what I'll do, just escape, shift color. You want to change one word. Instead of one word, you need to give you need to replace a different word. So I will do escape, shift color, then give one, then comma dollar, then space s, then old word. Suppose I want to change this change word, give change change, then slash edit slash g. Suppose instead of change I want to type edit, hit enter. See, now instead of change it's done, edited. Now it's written there, edit, something like that, right? Okay, now. So, yes, this is all about this. And if you want to save it, just escape, shift, color, WQ, excellent. Right? So, this is all about Visual Editor. If you want to open this file, again, the bias BIM, you can open by BIM also or DB. Correct only na or a DB test, BIM or a DB test. It's not opening BIM UTC SSH and SSHD underscore config by BIM, it's not opening anyway. So this is all about visual editor management, which is really helpful for you for your, you know, real environment, every day it used to be usable for you guys. It's very easy, right? Quite easy. If anyone still not understand it, any, I mean, the fresher guys and whoever you're going to learn the new things, if you are still unable to understand this, please give in the comment section so that I can you know, replay on over that comment, what was your issue and why you did not understand it. But yeah, before that, before writing your comment, I'd like to request you, okay, please go ahead twice or thrice, so I believe ki you will understand it. It's not a rocket science, so no need to worry about it. But still, I'd like to request you, please subscribe my channel and like and share my videos, so for that I can bring new tech solutions for your life, for your, you know, TL environment when you are facing any different kind of issue. According to that, if you follow my video session, so you can troubleshoot your problems as soon as possible. Okay. Anyway, this is all about for this video session, visual editor. Thanks to each one to following me. Please subscribe my channel.